Assalamualaikum, my name is Widi Mutakin. I am a bestseller author here in Udemy. I've been teaching computer graphics since the year 2000 and also founded several creative-based companies such as Blast2Code and Expos3D. In computer graphic world, there are two types of graphics, raster and vector. Both vector and raster graphic has their advantages and disadvantages. In this course, I will show you how to combine the best of two worlds, vector and raster, in a single workflow to create illustration fast. For dealing with raster graphic, we will use Adobe Photoshop, and for vector graphic, we will use Adobe Illustrator. The course is divided into six main sections. In the first section, we will cover the basics of Photoshop. This section is designed for complete beginners, so no experience needed to start from this section. We will start discussing the fundamentals of Photoshop, such as the UI, how to use the brush tool, the basic of working with layer, techniques to create and edit selection, using blending modes, creating image clipping and masking, and many other fundamental lessons. At the end of this section, we will have two projects. The first project is creating a typography poster like this. And the second project is cropping a rabbit photo and place it on another background. At the second section, we will cover more advanced topics on Photoshop, such as color models, image channels, hexadecimal color codes, different type of image file formats, and how to export them correctly. Then we'll move on to Photoshop filter, using gradient color, creating pattern, learn how to use the pen tool, and all the related tools in creating, editing, and managing vector paths inside Photoshop. The final project of this section is drawing this airplane illustration from sketch to finished artwork. At the third section of this course, we're going to focus more on advanced drawing techniques using only Photoshop. If before we only use our mouse, in this section, we'll start using pressure-sensitive devices such as Wacom tablet, learn how to customize Photoshop for speed, such as overriding the keyboard shortcut, creating custom brush, and defining and managing tool presets. At the end of this section, we're going to create a character design illustration using only Photoshop. We will start from zero, which is from sketching. Then we'll add colors to it. Then add more depth using shading and highlighting techniques. Finally, add color correction and visual effects on it. This is the final character illustration we're going to create in this section. Now, if these three previous sections cover only Photoshop, from this section, we will start learning the fundamental of Adobe Illustrator and vector graphics. If you never used Adobe Illustrator before, then this section is the best place to start. We will start from UI and navigation, then move on to selection and transformation. Next, we're going to cover vector shape creation, from simple primitive shapes to custom and complex shapes. We will discuss a lot of things in this section. And at the end of this section, you should be able to create simple logo and symbol, such as this Batman symbol. At the next section, we're going to cover several more advanced techniques in vector editing inside Adobe Illustrator. We're going to cover Pathfinder, Live Paint feature, how to create and manage width profile presets, also learn the strategy on how to use it. We will have two final projects in this section. Create flat style icon and create coloring pages illustration. Now, if you already take my course on vector illustration using Adobe Illustrator before, you can safely skip these two sections and move on to the final section of this course, because these two sections are also part of my other Adobe Illustrator course. So finally, this is the last section of the course. This is where we combine Photoshop and Illustrator together to create digital illustration fast. we're going to create an illustration from scratch using all of the techniques we've learned in previous lessons. We will start from sketching, move on to coloring, then shading, creating line artworks, texturing, to finally adding color correction and visual effects. This is the final illustration that we will be making in this course. The workflow is not like conventional digital painting method. It follows modern 3D computer graphic concepts. It is non-destructive and modular, so you should be able to adapt it to suit your own style. The skills you'll be learning from this course will be applicable to other type of artworks, such as UI design, logos, icons, creative advertising, etc. So, join now and leverage your graphic skills to the next level. See you on the other side. Wassalamualaikum.